Okay, so I'm gonna make a second plate. This time I'm gonna put, have the machine cut out just the text instead of cutting away the stuff and leaving the text, so you can see how the machine works differently with the same tool bit. So again, what I'm doing is marking the center. And it's really hard to see, so I'm gonna turn on my light so I can see it better. And so it looks like the center is right there. And then I'm gonna tape that down with my Turner's tape. So I'm gonna use that again. So I'm gonna flip this over. And I don't need very much of this, but the more I use, the better it sticks. So, and I want it to sit relatively flat. So that's gonna be pretty good. And then once I put this in again, I'm gonna set up the machine so that it's sending the next file. And because I took the last block off, I do need to reposition the tool bit. So what's different about this, I suppose if I made a jig, I could have this set up every time, but it's just, it's such a precise machine that it's good to mark the center point every time you do a run. It takes a little bit longer to do, but it's very reliable once you do it. So now that's set. So now what I'm going to do is stick it in, and I'm just kind of lining it up visually to make sure it's parallel to the plate. That looks pretty good. And I can actually push this back in, but I'll let the machine do that. Okay, so what I did is I finished that print job, and this is the prep software to send to the machine. So I'm going to hit finish, and I'm going to actually load in a new file for this one. So I'm going to go file, open. I'm not going to save my changes. And on that one, we cut away the material. Now I'm going to actually look at the hole. So what I'm going to do is cut into it. So I'm going to leave the block pretty much the way it is, and we're going to cut into it. I have this set up so it doesn't cut all the way down through the bottom of it. You could do that, and you could light it up from the backside with LEDs or any kind of thing you wanted to. So I'm going to keep it set this way. That looks fine. I am going to go to type of milling. On the last video, I forgot to change to the correct material, so I want to show you how to do that. Faster cutting time, it's flat planes or just drilling holes pretty much. What is going to be interesting is this part of the M won't get cut because it's too small. It's not wide enough. We're going to create the tool path, and on the last video I had this as styrene foam or polystyrene, so I had to switch it. The runtime is significantly longer. So again, here I'm going to put in the dimensions, which I'm going to just let the machine pick, even though my material is a little bit thicker than 15 millimeters, I'm going to just put that in. So it's not going to cut all the way to the very bottom, but it'll cut down far enough. So you notice this is a little bit wider than what I told you for the dimensions of the block that you're using. And you need to make that, always take that into consideration. So I'm going to align it to the top. Now the toolpath, like in the last one, we only have one bit that we're using. It's a flat 1/8-inch square bit. So for the roughing and for the finishing cut, if you were to change bits, it would pause and tell you to change the bits, but we're not going to do that.
So I'm going to create the toolpath. And once this is done, then I can preview the results. And you'll notice when I show you the preview this time, it's going to be about 8 hours. No, maybe not so much since it's only cutting holes. In the last one, it was quite a bit longer run for the different material. Yeah, so this is going to take 2.8 hours just to cut these holes. Very precise machine, but it doesn't run very fast. It's really similar to the 3D printers. The difference is that this is called subtractive, where the 3D printers are additive. This is cutting away material where the 3D printers are adding material. So that looks pretty good. I like that. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to pause this. I'm going to start recording my phone too so you can see what I need to do to set up the to set up the machine. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is open up the software to run the machine. I need to turn on the machine, so I just turned it on. And it's got to go through its little startup routine. Looks like it worked fine last time. It was about an 8-hour run. So it's waiting for the machine to initialize. And then what we're going to do is move the bit into the center position that I marked. And I'm going to move that by hand, so I'm going to change this to continuous because it moves faster. I'm moving it in the X, now the Y, and now the Z. And you got to be really careful when you move it in Z so you don't jam the bit into the block. That's not a good thing to do. So that's looking pretty close. I'm going to change now so I can get it close. And I want to move it a little bit more in the X and the Y. And then I'm going to place that piece of paper underneath like this just to make sure. So I've got a ways to go yet. And I need to move it a little bit more this way, it looks like. It doesn't have to be exact, especially if your piece of material is big enough. But I like to be precise because it's a really precise machine. And that little bit low because the paper doesn't go through. So I'm going to go up 10 units. Pretty good though. I think I'm going to leave it like that. Maybe one more up. Yeah, that looks good. So I'm going to take out my light. And then we need to zero the X and the Y, so that's what I'm going to do here, and then zero the Z. And now the machine and the computer know where the center of the block is. So now I'm going to jump back into the other software, and this is ready to go. Machine's ready to go. So I'm going to go down to perform cutting. And then start cutting. Remember again, this is how much of the length of the tool bit we need, and I've got plenty to go through because I'm not going all the way through it. So I'm going to hit start cutting. We're starting at the center, at the top, and here we go. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to pause this, and then we'll come back to it when it's finished. It's going to take about 3 hours to do that. So this one is finished, so I'm going to take it out now and show you what it looks like when it's done. And this one, we just cut away the holes out of it. We didn't do the relief like we did on the other one. So that one's ready to go. So here are the two different examples side by side. This is the one where we cut all the material away and left the letters. And this one we actually cut holes in. And you notice that this part was too thin for the bit to actually get in and cut, so it didn't do that.
So that's something that you have to be aware of when you design. And that's it for today. Have a nice day.